Jim runs the household like a dictatorship. It is his way or the highway. He wholeheartedly believes in anger, yelling, intimidation, and humiliation.
I expect discipline and respect. I intimidate so I don't have to get physical.
My children have had to endure verbal, emotional, and physical abuse.
He would take his fingers and poke them in the stomach to knock the wind out of them, which brought them to their knees.
My dad would get mad at us. He would push us against the wall and raise his fist at us and say, bam, bam, bam. He was trying to scare us and intimidate us. I was terrified that my dad was actually going to hit me in the face.
My philosophy is, if you strike your child with the intention of hurting them, that's abuse. If you do it with the intention of getting their attention, then that's not. That's the approach that I've tried to use parenting.
Jim has been very hard on Nick.
My dad was constantly yelling at Nick. Sometimes he would get so angry, he'd start spitting, turning red, and coughing because he'd be yelling so loud and so hard.
When Nick was 4, Jim yelled at him so loud that he actually peed on himself. Jim would hold him up against the wall by his neck. Jim would hit Nick and justify it by saying he only used an open hand. He has been even more abusive to Chloe.
My dad has held me down by my hair and raised his arm and threatened to hit me with his fist. He would leave bruises. One time we were at the dinner table and my dad got so aggravated with me that he stabbed the back of my hand with a carving fork at the Christmas dinner table.
5 years ago, Jim was arrested for screaming at us that he was going to brutalize the entire family.
I was the one who called the police.
Jim was arrested for assaulting a child and 5 counts of uttering threats.
The absurdity in all of this is that my dad plays the victim and says that he has never done anything wrong.
Jim has traumatized the entire family.
My dad needs to get through his head that he is the root of our family problems.
Because of Jim's verbal, emotional, and physical abuse, my son is a drug addict.
Well, Liz admits that she failed Nick and daughter Chloe by not protecting them. But she says she just was terrified of her husband's emotional, verbal, and financial abuse and manipulation.
I have known Jim for 28 years. Jim constantly berates me. Jim often calls me a bitch and the in front of the children and says that I'm nothing more than a car payment.
Liz lacks confidence, so Liz validates herself by being both a sex toy for me and by being the slave in the house.
If Jim doesn't like the tone of my voice or the way I respond to him, it is a huge trigger. He is constantly trying to control me. I have not worked out of the home for the past 19 years because Jim told me I didn't need to. And in the past, I had to show him receipts for everything, even if it was a pack of gum. Jim pays for everything, and if he cuts me off, I will not be able to survive. He's mean, he's angry.
You have to live in fear around my dad constantly.
I know there are many times I failed to protect my kids, but I am scared to death of him. If I speak out against Jim, he would lash out at me, and I don't know what we would do without his financial support. I have basically trained the children to watch out for any triggers in him just to keep the peace in the house. We don't know any other way to survive.
Okay, now you flew in separately from your husband and you haven't wanted to see him. Has that worked? Have you seen him?
I haven't seen him, but he's been texting me quite often.
Here are some excerpts of the text that he sent while you were in LA. He says, 2 weeks ago, I was, and he makes a very explicit sexual reference here about what he was doing with you sexually. And you were begging for more, and now not a peep. So here's what's going to happen. I'm pulling out of the show. I never want to see any of you ever again. Your gold-digging Black Widow ways will be over. I better get a phone call within 5 minutes. Then Jim, to your daughter Chloe, says, are you part of this? It's bleeping broken, with little chance of repair if she doesn't bleeping talk soon. Does he always threaten like this?
Always. It's constant.
That's just his way of managing.
Yep, that's his way.